thank you for watching this ASI Insider. I'm Susan Sutton, editor of Adhesives and Sealants Industry. And today I'm speaking with Bill Allmond. He's the president of the Adhesive and Sealant Council. Bill, hi.
Good morning, Susan.
So the Adhesive and Sealant Council determined just last month in December that you would postpone the World Adhesive and Sealant Conference, known as WAC, to next year, to 2022. Can you outline some of the factors that were taken into consideration when making that decision?
Of course. You know, I think first and foremost, just the safety and well-being of all of our attendees were at the top of our priority list. And just 2021 wasn't quite, we just weren't quite ready domestically or globally to bring the industry back together. But you know, I'm getting a lot of very positive feedback from our global partners in Europe and in Asia that 2022 really seems like the right time to do it. So that's what we're planning.
Okay, great. The ASE is planning to do an event, hopefully in person, maybe hybrid. We'll kind of see how things play out this fall. It'll be kind of like the annual convention and expo, and it will be held at the same time in the same place as the Executive Leadership Conference. Can you share details about those two events?
So yes, we decided to have a hybrid fall convention and expo, as well as our leadership conference together in Orlando, the week of October 25th. And so it was just really important for us to bring the industry back together to try this again. We tried to pull the industry back together in person last year, and it just obviously wasn't quite the time to do that, and held a virtual event instead. But so for this year, we feel like late October would be a great time to do this. Obviously, it's a lot dependent on the vaccine and how comfortable our members are on re-engaging in person. But that's why we're also making this a hybrid event as well. If someone wants to participate virtually, they'll have the option to do that. But we also thought it was important to, since we wanted to do the convention and expo and also our executive leadership conference, to do it the same week, to cut down on the amount of traveling that members would have to do for these two events. Just bring them together on the same week. That way, members, if they want to attend both, they can do it the same week. So we're really excited about both events. I'm hearing from members, they want to get back together. They want to see their customers. They want to see their suppliers through the ASC. And so I'm keeping my fingers crossed that the timing will be right, that we'll be in a much better place by the fourth quarter of this year in order to deliver those two marquee events for the ASC.
Yes, I think we're all definitely hopeful for that. We'll keep all of our fingers and toes crossed.
Right.
Can you share some details about other activities and initiatives the ASC is working on for this year?
Absolutely. Well, probably on the top of our priority list is redoing our strategic plan. So our last 3-year strategic plan ended at the end of the year last year. And so we are in the middle of working with our members to develop what the next 3-year strategic plan will look like. Just like any business or any product, the ASC has to continuously improve. We have to evolve with our members because demands and needs do change, particularly in these days. And so the ASC needs to always make sure that we maintain and meet the needs of our membership. So we'll be going through that process this year. We're also publishing the next North American market report, and we're working with our partners at ChemQuest to help put that together for the membership, and that should be available by April of this year. And we're doing a lot of the same sort of educational programming that a lot of the membership in the industry relies upon ASC to deliver through our training academy. So we've got some great webinars. We've got some great workshops, both virtual and in person, planned for this year as well.
Okay, Bill, thanks again for taking the time to talk with us today.
Thanks, Susan. It's always a pleasure.
And if you would like some more information about the ASC's activities or events, please take a look at ascouncil.org.